你们好，今天我们学第三课，时间。三 ，three， 第三 ，number three， 第三课 ，lesson three， 时间 ，time and dates。Let's start with dialogue one， 对话一。First of all, let's review the numbers. You will recognize why numbers are so important in this chapter when it comes to dates and time. Do you remember how to count from 0 to 99? Now, let's review how to say 0. 零 零 零 零 is 0. 怎么说 1? 很好一怎么说 ？Two， 二。Let's continue。三、四、五、六、七、八、九、十、十一、十二、十三、十四。十五、十六、十七、十八、十九、二十、二十一、二十二、二十三、二十四、二十五、二十六、二十七、二十八。二十九，三十，三十一。And I trust that you can continue counting until 99, 九十九。Now, how do we count beyond 99 to say 100 to 999? To say 100, it's 百，百，百。百 means 100. Now, 怎么说 100?很好 100 is 一百一百怎么说 200? 很好二百二百 300 三百三百 400 四百四百 500五百五百 600 六百六百 700 七百七百 800 八百八百 900 九百九百很好Now you can count from 0 to 900. Now, 怎么说? 101. 很好。一百零一。We read a 0 out. 很好。When you have a 0 in between numbers, we read a 0 out. So this is 一百零一。一百零一。怎么说 ?102. 很好。一百零二。一百零二。怎么说 ?103. 一百零三。一百零三。And you can count all the way to 109.一百零九 ，and 怎么说 ？110， 一百十，一百十。那怎么说 ？111， 一百十一，一百十一。很好。Now do you know how to count until 999? Now let's say 999. 怎么说 999? 999. 999. 999. 很好。Now, how do we indicate the day of the week? 星期。星期。星期 means week. 星期。Now, what is the first day of the week? We know actually in Western culture, the first day of the week is considered, Sunday is considered the first day of the week. However, in Asian culture, Monday is actually the first day of the week. So, in Asian culture, Chinese as well, Monday is the first day of the week. So, to say Monday, which is the first day of the week, we say 星期一。一 as in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, the one. So, actually, week, the day of the week, the first day of the week is 星期一。星期一。Could you guess how to say Tuesday? 很好。星期二。二 as in 1, 2, 星期二 Tuesday. Now, how do we say Wednesday? Could you guess? 很好。星期三 Wednesday. 星期三。Now, how about Thursday? 星期四。星期四。And Friday? 星期五。星期五。Saturday. 星期六。星期六。And Sunday. You probably were thinking, 星期七? No, it's not. Well, actually, every rule has its exception. And Sunday, in Bible, the God took a day off on the seventh day and took a rest. So Sunday is a very special day as well in Chinese. To say Sunday, it's either 星期天 or 星期日. So either 星期天 or 星期日. Now, 天, it means day or sky. 日 also means day or sun. So when you say 星期天, you know, it's Sunday. It's more colloquial. It's more informal. When you say 星期日, it's more written. It's more formal. So 星期天 is the informal way. It's the colloquial way to say Sunday. And 星期日 is the more written and formal way to say Sunday. All right. Did you remember? How do we indicate the day of the week? It's by saying 星期 plus either the number or the day, 天 or 日, to indicate the day of the week. Alright, let's review. Monday, 星期一. Tuesday, 星期二. Wednesday, 星期三. Thursday, 星期四. Friday, 星期五. Saturday, 星期六. And Sunday, that's the special day, 星期天 or 星期日. Now, once again, remember to say Sunday, it's the special day, it's not 星期七, it's either 星期日 or 星期天. Did you remember which one is written, which one's spoken, which one's formal, which one's informal? 很好。星期日 is used more in written Chinese.And 星期天 is more used in spoken Chinese. It's the colloquial version of Sunday. 很好。Now let's quickly review. 怎么说 Monday? 很好。星期一 Tuesday. 星期二 Wednesday. 星期三 Thursday. 星期四 Friday. 星期五Saturday, 星期六, and Sunday, 星期天, or the other way is 星期日, 很好。So we know to indicate the day of the week, you just say 星期, then plus the word to indicate the day of the week. 很好。Now, we have 星期 plus the X number, the indefinite number, to indicate the day of the week. And actually, this is the informal and spoken way to say the day of the week. We have another way, which is more formal and more return, which is 周 plus the day of the week. 周, 周, 周 also means week. So you can say Monday is also 周一, and Tuesday is 周二, and Wednesday, 周三, Thursday, 周四, Friday, 周五, Saturday, 周六. Now, how do we say Sunday? We know when we were using 星期, there are two ways to say Sunday. One is 星期天, the other one is 星期日. Now that we are using 周, which is the formal and written way, which one do you think we use with 周? 很好, it's 周日, because 日 is the more formal way. Since 周 is also the formal and written way, it goes with formal, 日. 很好, now to say Sunday with 周 is 周日, 周日. To say weekend, 周末, 周末. 周 means week, and 末 means end. So literally, it's weekend, 周末, 周末. Now, 听好, 今天是星期一. Or you can say, 今天是星期二. 今天是星期三, 今天是星期五. You can fill in the blank with whatever you want to say. Now, 今天是什么? 很好, 今天, today. 今天, 今天. To say tomorrow, it's 明天, 明天. And yesterday, 昨天, 昨天. 今天, 明天, 昨天. Today, tomorrow, yesterday. Now, 听好, listen. 今天是星期二吗? 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 什么意思? What's the meaning of the sentence? 今天是什么? 很好, today. 是, 很好, M is R to B. 星期二, Tuesday. And 吗? Makes a yes on the question. So the sentence is, today is Tuesday? Question mark. So is today Tuesday? 很好. Now what if we want to say yes? 很好. To say a quick yes, it's 是. You can say 是, comma, 今天是星期二. Yes, today is Tuesday. If you want to say no, you can say 不是, no. 今天不是星期二. Today is not Tuesday. 不是, 今天不是星期二. Now if I say 明天是星期五吗? 明天是星期五吗? 什么意思? 很好, 明天, tomorrow, 星期五, Friday. Is tomorrow Friday? 明天是星期五吗? How do we say a quick yes? 很好, 是. You can say, yes, tomorrow is Friday. 是, 明天是星期五. What if we want to say no, tomorrow is not Friday? 不是, 明天不是星期五. 昨天是星期五. 星期天吗？昨天是星期天吗？昨天是星期天吗？昨天是什么？很好 ,yesterday, 星期天 ,Sunday, was yesterday Sunday? What if you want to say, yes, yesterday was Sunday? 是，昨天是星期五。No, yesterday was not Sunday. 不是，昨天不是星期五。很好。Now, how do we ask the question to say, what day of the week is it today? What day of the week is it today? Now, think about it. In most cases, which is the key word that indicates the day of the week? 很好。It's a number, right? Now, if you don't know how to form the question directly, let's give a random answer. So, let's start with a statement. Give a random answer. Let's say,Today is Wednesday.
今天是星期三。
So we formed a random statement to say today is Wednesday.
今天是星期三。
Now the next step. Let's replace the answer with the question pronoun. Which exact part in this sentence that tells you which day of the week it is?
今天是星期三。
很好。The exact part that tells you the day of the week is the number 三. Because we know whichever day of the week you are saying, the 星期 is always there. 星期一、星期二、星期三、星期四、星期五、星期六、星期天。很好。So we replace the 三, which tells us which day of the week it is, with the question pronoun, which is the question pronoun that we use to replace the number. 很好。几。So we replace the number 三 with the question pronoun 几。Which we will have the answer,
今天是星期几？今天是星期几？
Now you have the question to say, what day of the week is it today?
今天是星期几？
Now to ask the question, what day of the week is it tomorrow?
明天是星期几？明天是星期几。
Now, what if you want to ask, what day of the week was it yesterday?
很好。昨天是星期几。昨天是星期几。
Remember, whenever you're replacing a number, you use 几 to ask about the number. Question pronoun 几。很好。Now, once again, to ask the day of the week of today, tomorrow, or yesterday, it's
今天是星期几 or 明天是星期几 or 昨天是星期几。
Now, how do we say this week, last week, next week? First of all, how do we say week? 怎么说 week?
很好。星期，星期。
So to say this week, we know the word this, which is
这，这。
We know whenever you have a this or that or a number to modify the noun, what do we need in between?
很好。
We need a measure word in between. So to say this week, it's
这个星期，这个星期。
To say last week or this week or next week. Now, Chinese timeline runs from above to below. Above you, that's the past tense. That's the time that has passed, the earlier time. And below you, it's the future. It's the later time. So, to indicate next week or last week, we say
下个星期。
The week that's below you, that's in the future, that's coming up.
下个星期。
And to say last week, that's the week has already passed you, That's above you. 上个星期 last week. Once again, this week, 这个星期 next week, 下个星期 and last week, 上个星期 Now, we have learned already how to say different days of the week. How do we indicate the 12 months? First of all, to say months, it's 月月月月 means month. 月 also means the moon. 月 The 12 months, we just put the number before the word month, 月, to indicate different months of the year. So the first month, January, as long as it's the first month, so we say 一月一月 January. February, which is the second month, 二月二月 March, 三月三月 April, 四月四月 May, 五月五月 June, 六月六月 July, 七月七月 August, 八月八月 September, 九月九月 October, 十月十月 November, 十一月十一月 December, 十二月十二月 As you can see that we use the number 1 through 12 to indicate the 12 months of the year. So all you have to do is put the number before 月 to indicate different months of the year. From 一月 all the way to 十二月 Now let's review.怎么说 January 一月 February 二月 March 三月 April 四月 May 五月 June 六月 July 七月 August 八月September, 九月 October, 十月 November, 十一月 December, 十二月 Now, how do we indicate this month, next month, and last month? Remember how we said this week, last week, next week?So let's review this week, next week, and last week. To say this week, we said 这个星期 Next week, 下个星期 Last week, 上个星期 Could you guess how to say this month, next month, and last month? 很好这个月 this month 这个月 this monthNext month, 下个月下个月 And last month, 上个月上个月很好 Now, how do we ask about the months to say which month is it? What month is it? So first of all, let's start with a statement. Let's say this month isFebruary. So, to say this month again, 这个月 is February. 这个月是二月。这个月是二月。And then the next step, replace the answer with the question pronoun. Now, which exact part in the sentence, 这个月是二月, tells you which month it is? 很好。The answer is the number 2 here.
tells you which month it is. So let's replace the number 二 with the question pronoun. Which question pronoun should we use to replace 二, a number? 很好, it's 几. 几 is the question pronoun that always asks about a number. So, 这个月是几月? Which month is it this month? 这个月是几月?这个月是几月? Remember that the word order in a sentence, in a question or in a sentence do not change at all. 这个月是几月? Now to ask the question, which month is it this week, this month, next month, or last month? 这个月 or 上个月 or 下个月是几月? The answer, you would just replace 几 with the number to indicate the month. Alright, now 听好, listen. 这个月是几月?这个月是几月? Could you tell me the answer? Could you answer my question? 这个月是几月? Which month is this month? Good. 这个月是十二月。这个月是十二月。这个月是几月?这个月是几月?这个月是九月。这个月是九月。这个月是几月?这个月是几月?很好。这个月是四月。这个月是四月。这个月是几月?这个月是几月?这个月是二月。这个月是二月。这个月是几月?这个月是几月?这个月是七月。这个月是七月。这个月是几月?这个月是几月?这个月是十一月。这个月是十一月。Now, we've learned how to indicate the day of the week and which month it is. How do we indicate the dates of the month? We use the word 号. 号 or 日. 日. 号 is the informal one and 日 is the formal one. So, in spoken Chinese, 号, which is a major word for number in a series, is used to refer to the days of the month. For example, you can say 一号, the first day of the month. 二号, the second day of the month. 三号, the third day of the month. Or all the way to 三十号, the 30th day of the month. Or 三十一号, the 31st. 号. In written Chinese, 日 is always used. So you can say 一日, 二日, 三日, all the way to 三十日, 三十一日. On a calendar, you will never see the word 号. As it's written, you will always see 日. So, how do we ask, what day of the month is it today? Now remember, we use the number before 号 or 日 to indicate the day of the month. So, what you can do is, if you don't know how to say what day of the month it is today to form the question directly. You could give a random answer to say, today is the third. And then replace the number with the question pronoun we always use to replace numbers, which is 几. So to say, what day of the day is it? What day of the month is it today? You can say, 今天, today, 是几号? Today is which day of the month? 今天是几号? 今天是几号? Now, how do we express the date? So which includes the month and the day of the month? We say number 月, number 号. So this indicates the month, and here indicates the day. Or if you want to do the formal way, the written way, you can say number 月, number 日, which is the formal way. So let's try it. Now, in spoken Chinese, 号 is used, and in written Chinese, 日 is always used. 怎么说? January the 3rd. 很好。一月三号。Or we can say 一月三日。February the 5th. 二月五号。Or we can say 二月五日。March the 13th. 三月十三号。Or 三月十三日。July the 28th. 七月二十八号。Or 七月二十八日。August the 30th. 八月三十号。Or 八月三十日。December 31st. 十二月三十一号。Or 十二月三十一日。Now, how do we ask, what date is it today? So you're asking about the month, you're also asking about the date. Once again, if you don't know how to form the question directly, give it a random answer to say, today is January the 3rd. And then replace the number indicates the month and the number indicates the day of the month with the question pronoun 几. So let's just give a random answer to say, today is January the 1st. 今天是一月三号。今天是一月三号。And then we replace the numbers with the question pronoun 几. And we will have 今天是几月几号。今天是几月几号。Now I'm going to ask you a random date. And I want you to tell me which date it is in Chinese. So you want to tell me which month, which day. And if you can, which day of the week as well. For example, 二月三号星期五。二月三号星期五。Now you try it. 很好。七月十一号星期三。七月十一号星期三。Let's try another one. 很好。九月二十九号星期六。九月二十九号星期六。Let's try one last one. 很好。十二月二十五号星期二。
12月25号，星期二。
All right, now let's try something. How do we indicate, how do we ask, which day of the week is it for this day? For example, if I want to say, which day of the week is, let's assume this is October. So which day of the week is October the 16th? So you want to say, October the 16th is which day of the week?
10月16号是星期几？十月十六号是星期几？
To answer the question, you can say, 十月十六号是星期三。
十月十六号是星期三。
All right, I'm going to ask, pick a random day to ask you, and I want you to answer my question.
十月二十七号，十月二十七号是星期几？十月二十七号是星期几？
很好，
十月二十七号是星期天。十月二十七号是星期天。
这是什么？这是什么？很好，
生日，生日，生日
，birthday。Shen literally means to give birth to. Ri means the day. So the day you were given birth to, that's your birthday.
生日。
那怎么说 my birthday?
我的生日。
Your birthday.
你的生日。
His birthday.
他的生日。
Her birthday.
他的生日。
It's birthday,
他的生日。
很好。So, 我的生日，你的生日，他的生日。那怎么说 my birthday is June the 21st?
我的生日是六月二十一号。我的生日是六月二十一号。
那怎么说 Miss Zhang's birthday is January the 3rd?
张老师的生日是一月三号。张老师的生日是一月三号。
Now, how do we ask the question, when is Ms. Zhang's birthday? So you're asking about the month, you're also asking about the day of the month. So let's take a look at the previous statement we formed.
张老师的生日是一月三号。
Which words in this sentence tells you when Ms. Zhang's birthday is? Which month, which day of the month?
很好。一。And 三 tells us the month and the day of the month.
So let's replace 一 and 三 with the question pronoun we always use to replace numbers, which is 几很好。So we will have the question,
张老师的生日是几月几号？张老师的生日是几月几号？
Now, 怎么说 when's your birthday? If you don't know how to form the question directly, remember you can always form a random answer to say your birthday is January the 3rd. Then replace the words that tells you the answer with the question pronoun, 几。
很好。 你的生日是几月几号？你的生日是几月几号？
Now how do we answer this question? To say my birthday is this day, this month, and this day of the month.
很好，我的生日是
this month and this day of the month. Number 月 number 号。
我的生日是。
Now, how do we say his birthday or her birthday is?
他的生日是
number 月 number 号。
他的生日是
number 月 number 号。那怎么说 ？Today is my birthday。怎么说 ？Today。
很好，今天，今天是我的生日。今天是我的生日。今天是我的生日。
怎么说 ？Really？Is it really? To say, is it really? We say, 是吗？
是吗？是吗？
Is it really? Now, 是吗？ It means, is it really? It's to indicate how surprised you are. You didn't know it before, so now you're surprised.
是吗？
Now, 怎么说？ January the 3rd was a Friday.That day was my birthday. That day. 怎么说 that?
很好。那。
怎么说 day?
很好。天。
So that day.
那天。
那天。Was
是
my birthday,
我的生日。一月三号
or you can say 一月三日，
是星期五。那天是我的生日。
怎么说 ？Really, happy birthday. Really, once again,
是吗？是吗
？Happy birthday,
生日。快乐，
生日 is birthday. 快乐 means happy, so have a happy birthday.
生日快乐，
是吗？
生日快乐。
Now, when it's someone's birthday, oftentimes you will say, "Hey, how old are you?" So how do we ask about the age? You can say,
你今年多大？你今年多大？
今年 is this year.
今年，今年，
今 as in 今天 means the present. 年 is the year. So the present year is this year.
今年。
多大 means how old. How old. Now, 多 it's an adverb. It means how many, how much. And 大 it's an adjective. It means big. So 多大。It means how old. It also indicates literally how big are you this year. Essentially, when you were an infant, you grow bigger and bigger as you grow older. So that's why 多大 can also be referred to as someone's age to say how old. So to say how old are you this year,
你今年多大？你今年多大？
And to answer, you can say
我今年十八岁，我今年十八岁，
今年 this year，
十八
18，
岁
is the year of age，
岁，岁，岁。
So when you say 我今年十八岁 ，I'm 18 this year。今年 is a time expression. It's part of the adverbial. That's why we put it before, after the subject, before the verb.
我今年十八岁。
As you can see that the verb 是 is omitted here. It should be 我今年是十八岁。However, when you're talking about the age, the verb 是 is oftentimes omitted. 我今年十八岁。Now, is there another way to ask someone's age? If I just gave you the answer, 我今年十八岁, which part tells you how old this person is? 很好,十八, the number. Now, which question pronoun do we use to replace a number? 很好,几. So you can also ask, how old are you this year by saying, 你, remember to change the personal pronoun from 我 to 你. 你今年多,对不起,你今年几岁?你今年几岁? So we replaced 十八 with the question pronoun 几 to ask about the year of age. 你今年几岁? Now, how do we ask someone's age this year? You can either say, somebody 今年多大? How old is someone this year? Somebody 今年多大? Or you can ask, somebody 今年几岁? How old is someone this year? 今年几岁? The subject is here. And to answer both questions, you can say, somebody is number years old, so somebody 今年 number 岁. Somebody 今年 number 岁, to indicate the age. Now, we have learned the month, the day of the month, the day of the week. How do we indicate the years? For example, this year, 1987. We know the word to say year is 年, as in 今年, this year. 年 is year. How do we read the year 1987? In Chinese, we don't do the way as we do in English, as we say 1987 in English. We actually read one digit at a time. So one digit at a time, and then we put 年 afterwards to indicate it's a year, it's not a random number. So the year 1987, if we read it one digit at a time, 1987, remember to put the 年 at the end, 年. So now we know it's a year, it's not a random number. Again, year in Chinese are read one digit at a time, followed by 年. 1987. How about this one? 1543. 2013. 2013年二零一三年 2008. 2008年二零零八年很好 Now how do we say last year, this year, or next year? We have learned this year already, which is 今年, 今年. How do we say next year or last year? Let's give you a hint. How do we say yesterday, today, and tomorrow? 今天 is today. 明天, tomorrow. 昨天, yesterday. We know 今天 is today. And how do we say how we say this year? 今年很好, guess how we say next year? 明年很好, how do we say last year? It's not 昨年. This is the special one. To say last year, it's 去年. 去年. 去 literally means go. And 年 means year. The year that has already gone. That's last year. 去年. And 今年, 今天, 明年, 明天, these two are similar. And remember, 去年 is the different one. 去年, not 昨年. Now, 怎么说? This year is 2013. 很好。今年是2013年。今年是2013年。Last year was 1967. Remember, last year is a different one. 很好。去年。去年是1967年。去年是1967年。Next year is 2002. 明年，明年是2002年。明年是2002年。Remember that whenever you're indicating the year, 年 has to be after the number, otherwise it's just a random number. 那怎么说？What year is it this year? What year is it this year? So you're literally saying this year is this year. Whenever you're asking about the year, usually you don't know, you're not so sure about the last digit or the last two digits. You usually know the first two digits. So to ask what year is it this year? Usually you will say 今年是几几年? So usually...Typically, you will ask about the last two digits of the year. 今年是几几年?今年是几几年? This year is 2013. 今年是2013年。今年是2013年. How about next year? 怎么说? How about? So you know the question is very clear from the context to say how about the question pronoun. 很好, you want to say 明年呢? 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 那怎么说? My birthday is June the 28th, 1993. My birthday is June the 28th, 1993. Now we have different elements of the time. How do we arrange this time? We have the month, we have the day of the month, we have the year. Chinese time expression.Proceed from the largest to the smallest. So here, what's the largest unit? The year, obviously. And the next one is the month and then the day of the month. So to say my birthday is June the 28th, 1993, you want to make sure you translate the year first because it's from bigger to smaller. So the sentence is 我的生日是一九九三年六月二十八号，我的生日是一九九三年六月二十八号。Or you can say 六月二十八日 if you want to be more formal. 我的生日是一九九三年。六月二十八号。怎么说 today is Sunday, December the 8th, 2013? Again, think about the order, how we arrange the time expressions. So here you have the day of the week, the month, the day of the month, and then the year, which is the biggest unit. 很好, the year obviously is the biggest unit, and then the month, and then the day of the month, and then the day of the week. So the sentence is, 今天是2013年12月8号星期天。今天是2013年12月8号星期天。Time expression goes from the biggest to the smallest. Now, if you want to say tomorrow is, you can say 明天是. Once again, bigger to smaller, year, month, day of the week. And if you want to say yesterday, it's 昨天,昨天是. Once again, the order for time expression goes from the biggest to the smallest. So usually year goes first, and then month, and then day of the month, and day of the week. How do we ask about the year, the month, and the day? So if we want to say which year, usually as we said, you are either not sure about the last digit or the last two digits. So oftentimes you will just say 几几年, which year? So 几几 is to ask about the last two digits. Or you can say, if you, for example, if you know it's 2000 something, 2000, either it's 12, 2013 or 2014, you're not sure about the last digit, you can also say 2010几年. So you're just asking about the last number, the last digit of the year. 2010几年. To ask which month, you will just say 几月, 几月, 月 is the month, 几月. Or which day of the month, 几号, 几号. So we have 几几年, or 二零一几年, 几月, or 几号. If you want to say which day of the week, you can say 星期几, 星期几, which day of the week. Now we have learned the week, which is 星期, the month, which is 月, the day of the month, which is 号, or 日. Also, we learned the year, 年. How do we tell time on a clock? First, let's start from the easiest. Let's learn how to say the shop hours. You know, so like 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock. To say o'clock, it's 点钟. 点钟. 钟 can be omitted. 点 is a measure word to say o'clock, and 钟 is actually the clock, the noun. 点钟, o'clock. So to say what, you know, whichever shop hour of on the clock, it's 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, you just put a number before 点钟. Once again, 钟 can be omitted. You can say 一点钟, for example, which is 1 o'clock. 一点钟. Now, how do we say 2 o'clock? Do we say 二点钟, or do we say 两点钟? Remember the difference between 二and 两. 很好. Here we actually say 两点钟, because as we said, 点 is a measure word. In front of a measure word to express the quantity of 2, it's always 两. So 两点钟, or you can say 两点, either way. 3 o'clock. 三点钟. 三点钟. You can say all the way to 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 四点钟,五点钟,六点钟. Now, 怎么说? 12 o'clock. 很好,十二点钟,十二点钟,点钟, to indicate a sharp hour. Now, how about you want to say, it's 8 o'clock now, it's 8 o'clock now. To say now, it's 现在, 现在,
现在。When you say it's 8 o'clock now, it's the same to say now is 8 o'clock. Now is 8 o'clock.
现在是八点钟。
现在是八点钟。As we said earlier, whenever you're talking about age, the verb 是 can be omitted. Once again, whenever you're talking about the time on a clock, actually the verb 是 can also be omitted. So you can say 现在是八点钟 or you can say 现在八点钟。Now, how do we ask about the time to say what time is it now? So just now we formed a sentence to say 现在八点钟。Which part in this sentence that tells you what time it is?
现在八点钟。
很好, the number 八 here tells you what time it is. So we replace the answer 八 with the question pronoun, which is the question pronoun that replaces numbers.
很好。几?
So we will have the question, what time is it now?
现在几点钟?
现在几点钟? What time is it now?
现在几点钟?
Now, we've learned how to indicate a sharp hour. How do we indicate a half hour? To say half an hour, or half,
半,
半, 半, 半 means half an hour, or half. To say half an hour, it's number 点, indicate the hour, and plus half an hour. Number 点半, number 点半. For example, 1:30,
一点半,
一点半. 2:30, 很好。两点半,
两点半,
we do not say 二点半, because 点 is a measure word. 两点半, 5:30, 很好, 五点半,
五点半,
7:30, 七点半,
七点半。
11:30, 十一点半，
十一点半。
How do we indicate a quarter of an hour?
课，
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 课 is quarter of an hour or 15 minutes. 那怎么说 2:15? Now, first of all, in the expression 2:15, how many quarter or 15 minutes there are in 2:15, the 15 here?
很好, just one.
So we say 两点一刻. So 两点 indicates it's 2 o'clock. 一刻 indicates on top of the 2 o'clock, there's a quarter, there's 1:15 minutes. So 两点一刻. How about 4:15? 很好,四点一刻, 4 o'clock plus 1 quarter, 四点一刻。6:15, 六点一刻,
六点一刻。
10:15, 十点一刻,
十点一刻。
So to indicate the sharp hour plus 1 quarter, it's number 点一刻. So this hour plus 15 minutes plus a quarter. Number 点一刻. Now how do we say 2:45? How many quarters, how many 15 minutes are there in 45? 很好, there are 3 quarters, 3 15 minutes. So we say this is 两点三刻, 3 quarters. 两点三刻.
4:45.
四点三刻。四点三刻。
6:45.
六点三刻。六点三刻。
10:45.
十点三刻。十点三刻。
So if there are 3/4 or 45 minutes, it's number 点三刻 3/4, 45 minutes. Number 点三刻。
那怎么说 7:30?
Can we say 七点两刻 or 七点二刻？
No, because we have another word that's half an hour, which is 半。很好, so to say 7:30, it's 七点半。七点半。We will never say 七点两刻 or 七点二刻, never.
What if we have a random minute? It's not a quarter, it's not half an hour, it's not shop hour. So how do we indicate the random minutes?To say minute, it's 分, 分, minute. So indicating a random hour and a random minute, it's number 点, number 分, number 点, number 分. For example, 1:20. 一点二十分, 一点二十分。
Fen can be omitted from the end of the expression if the number of the minutes appear in two syllables, two digits. So here, 20 is two syllables, it's two digits. So we can actually omit a fen here. You can say 一点二十分, or you can say 一点二十。
How about 2:43?
两点四十三分, or you can omit a fen.Remember, it's 两, as 点 is a measure word. 两点四十三分。两点四十三分。
5:19.
五点十九分。五点十九分。Or 五点十九, omitting the 分。
8:36.
八点三十六分。八点三十六分。八点三十六分。怎么说
？10:59.
十点五十九分。十点五十九分。
11:03.
十一点零三分。Remember that when we have a single digit on the minute, we read a zero out. 十一点零三分。So the term 零, 0, is usually added before a single-digit number of 分 minute. Let's try another one.
12:08. 12:08. 12:08. 3:07. 3:07.三点零七分。
Now, if you want to ask, what time is right now? 现在几点钟? If it's a sharp an hour, you can say 现在 number 点钟, if it's a sharp hour. If it's a half an hour, you can say 现在 number 点半. If it's a quarter or 3/4, 现在 number 点一刻 or 三刻。If it's a random number, you can say 现在 number 点 number 分。
Alright, now how do we indicate the different block of the day, like morning, noon, afternoon, and evening? To say early morning, which is usually from 5:30 to 8 o'clock in the morning, 早上早上早上早 means early, 早上 as we said, 上 indicates an earlier time, so 早上 means early morning. 怎么说 good morning? 早上好早上好 good morning. Now, to say morning from 8 o'clock to 11:30, so it's no longer early morning, 上午上午 Now, 怎么说 9:45 a.m. Remember, how do you arrange the time expressions from what to what? 很好, from bigger unit to the smaller unit. So, obviously, morning, a.m., is the bigger one, and 9:45 is just a point on a clock, so this is the smaller version. So, 9:45 a.m. is 上午九点四十五分 Or you can say 上午九点三刻上午九点三刻 Now to say noon, it's 中午中午 noon. You probably noticed that here 午 and 午午 means noon, 上 means earlier, so earlier than noon, that's morning, and 中 means middle, in the middle of the noon, that's noon. So usually this time block is from 11:30 to 12:30. 中午那怎么说 12 p.m. As we know, 12 p.m. is noon time, so we don't say, you know, afternoon, actually, we say 中午十二点中午十二点 Now, to say afternoon, it's 下午下 indicates a later time, later than noon, it's afternoon 下午下午 usually from 12:30 to 5:30 那怎么说 4:02 p.m. 很好下午四点零二分下午四点零二分 Remember to read the zero out. And evening, 晚上晚上 evening, 晚 means late, 晚上 So 晚上 is usually from 5:30 to 12 a.m. 晚上那怎么说 good evening? 晚上好晚上好怎么说 11:09 p.m. 晚上十一点零九分晚上十一点零九分 Alright, let's review the time. 现在几点钟? What time is it now? 现在几点钟?很好,现在五点十五分 5:15 现在五点十五分 Or you can say 现在五点一刻 quarter 现在五点一刻现在几点钟现在几点钟 It's 4:01 现在几点钟很好现在四点零一分现在四点零一分 Remember when we have a single digit on the minute, we read a zero out.现在几点钟现在几点钟 6:30 现在几点钟很好现在六点半现在六点半 half an hour
现在几点钟？现在几点钟？ What time is it now? 7:40. 很好。现在7:40。现在7:40。现在几点钟？ 3:05.现在3:05。现在3:05。现在几点钟？现在几点钟？很好。It's 9:55。现在9:55。现在9:55。现在几点钟？ 11:45。现在11:45。现在11:45。Or you can also say, 现在11:03, 3/4. 现在11:03. Once again, the order of time words, it's from bigger unit to the smaller unit. So usually you have the year, and then the month, the day of the month, the day of the week, and then if it's evening, morning, noon, and then the time on the clock. So from bigger to smaller. Now, 听好。如果我告诉你今天是我的生日，你怎么办？ If I tell you that today is my birthday, what would you do? 很好， you can say happy birthday to me, you can sing happy birthday song for me, or you can invite me to dinner or to a meal together. So, to say 我请你吃晚饭，我请你吃晚饭。请 means please, as we learned from lesson 1, 请问。And 请 has a new meaning as a verb. It means to invite, to treat. So you can invite someone to do something, to treat someone to do something. For example, you can invite someone to watch a movie, to treat someone to eat dinner, to invite someone to dance. So 请 is to invite, to treat. And 吃 means to eat. 吃吃 to eat. 晚饭晚饭晚饭 means dinner. 晚 literally means late. 饭 means meal. So the late meal is 晚饭. So, dinner. So when you say person A, 请 person B, verb object, it's actually a pattern to say person A treats person B to do something together, and person A is paying, as it's his treat. Now let's go back to the sentence earlier. 我请你吃晚饭。我请你吃晚饭。什么意思？ What's the meaning of it? 我是什么？ I, 请 to invite, to treat. 你 you, 吃 to eat. 晚饭 dinner. So I will treat you to eat dinner. 我请你吃晚饭。A, 请 B, verb object.很好， remember this little pattern. A, 请 B, verb object. Person A treats person B to do something. 那怎么说？ She treats me to eat a meal. As we said, 晚 means late, 饭 means a meal. So 饭 is any meal. 很好，她请我吃饭。她请我吃饭。Usually, Chinese verbs take an object afterwards. So, 吃饭 means to eat a meal, eat a meal. It doesn't necessarily have to be dinner. If you want to say dinner, it's 晚饭. But if you just say 吃饭, it's just to eat a meal. 他请我吃饭。那怎么说 his mom treats us to eat dinner? 他妈妈请我们吃晚饭。他妈妈请我们吃晚饭。
My friends and I will treat our teacher to eat dinner on Thursday. Now, where do you put the time expression? Remember the sentence pattern in Chinese. Subject, adverbial, verb, object. What does adverbial mean? Adverbial indicates time, place, manner, and adverb. Now we have learned a lot of time expressions in lesson 3. So where do we put on Thursday the time expression?
很好, as adverbial before the verb and after the subject.
So let's try it. My friend and I, that's the subject, let's translate this part first.
我的朋友和我.
And now do we have any adverbial like time, place, manner, adverb? 很好, yes we do. We have on Thursday. So let's put on Thursday next.
星期四.
We'll treat our teacher to eat dinner. Verb,
请我们的老师吃晚饭.
Okay, the sentence once again is 我的朋友和我星期四请我们的老师吃晚饭. Remember that now that we have a lot of time expressions, they go before the verb and after the subject as adverbial. Alright, let's do more examples. 怎么说? I will treat my girlfriend to eat Chinese food on Saturday. Now, 怎么说? Chinese food. Chinese food is Chinese cuisine. It's 菜. 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 Dishes or cuisine. So to say Chinese food, it's 中国菜. 中国菜. How about American cuisine?
美国菜，美国菜。
Now let's try this sentence. I will treat my girlfriend to eat Chinese food on Saturday.
我
Now do we translate Saturday next or do we put it at the very end of the sentence? 很好 On Saturday is a time expression. It functions as an adverbial element. Goes before the verb and after the subject. So
我星期六请我的女朋友吃中国菜。我星期六请我的女朋友吃中国菜。我星期六请我的女朋友吃中国菜。
Now, how do we form the question to say, who would you treat to eat Chinese food on Saturday? From the previous sentence we formed,
我星期六请我的女朋友吃中国菜。
Which part tells you who would you treat?
很好,我的女朋友。
That's the answer.So let's replace 我的女朋友 with the question pronoun who, 谁. Now you have the question
你 from 我 to 你你星期六请谁吃中国菜你星期六请谁吃中国菜
Now, 怎么说? My parents will treat me to eat American cuisine at 7 o'clock on Sunday evening. Now, here we have different elements of time expression here. What is the order to arrange all the time expressions? We have 7 o'clock, we have Sunday, we have evening. What's the order to arrange them? 很好, from bigger to smaller. So, which is the bigger unit? 很好, Sunday is the bigger one. And then...evening, and then 7 o'clock. 很好. Now the next question is where do we put those time expressions in the sentence? 很好. We put them after the subject and before the verb as adverbial. So let's try this. my parents.
我的爸爸妈妈。星期天晚上七点钟请我吃美国菜。我爸爸妈妈星期天晚上七点钟请我吃美国菜。我爸爸妈妈星期天晚上七点钟请我吃美国菜。
What if I want you to form the question to say, who will treat you to eat American cuisine at 7 o'clock on Sunday morning, Sunday evening? Where's your answer?
很好。我的爸爸妈妈 is your answer in the previous sentence.
So let's replace 我的爸爸妈妈 with the question pronoun who. Therefore, we'll have the sentence
谁星期天晚上七点请你吃美国菜。谁星期天晚上七点请你吃美国菜。
Now, what if we want to form the question to say, what would your parents treat you at 7 o'clock on Sunday evening? Where's your answer to what?
我爸爸妈妈星期天晚上七点请我吃美国菜。
很好, the answer is 美国菜, American cuisine. So let's replace 美国菜 with the question pronoun what?
什么?
And then you will have the question.
你的爸爸妈妈星期天晚上七点请你吃什么？你的爸爸妈妈星期天晚上七点请你吃什么？
All right, now if you want to ask, who are you treating to eat? You can say,你请谁吃饭? You are treating whom to eat meal?
你请谁吃饭?
And you can answer the question by saying 我请 somebody 吃饭. So I'm treating this person to eat. 我请 somebody eat. What are you treating him or her?
你请他吃什么?
You treat him or her eat what?
你请他吃什么?
I will treat her or him eat this.
我请他吃
cuisine, whatever cuisine you're here, you're treating the person here. So,
你请谁吃饭?
我请 this person 吃饭。
你请他吃什么?
What are you treating him or her?
我请他吃 whatever.
Alright, now 怎么说? I will treat you to eat dinner on Sunday evening. How does that sound?Now let's first translate the first part of the sentence. I will treat you to eat dinner on Sunday evening. Do we have an adverbial, a time expression here, that we need to put before the verb and after the subject?
很好,
yes, we have Sunday evening here. So it needs to go before the verb as adverbial. So,
我星期天晚上请你吃晚饭。
How does that sound?
怎么样?怎么样 means,
is that okay? How does that sound?
怎么样?怎么样?
So, 我星期天晚上请你吃晚饭怎么样?怎么样 is used to ask for an opinion after making a suggestion. Usually what you do is you put your suggestion, whatever you want to suggest first, and then check the other person's opinion to say, 怎么样? How does that sound? What do you think? Is that okay? So, suggestion, 怎么样? Now, 怎么说? Great, thank you. To say great, it's extremely good. To say extremely, it's 太了。Usually, between 太 and 了, it's an adjective here. 太, adjective, 了, it's extremely adjective, too adjective. Now, to say great, it's extremely good. So, 太好了, 太好了, thank you, Now, too expensive, 怎么说 extremely expensive, too expensive? 太怎么说 expensive, do you remember? It's the same word as to say honorable in lesson 1.1. 很好，太贵了，太贵了。Too tall, 怎么说 too tall? 太高了，高 tall, or it's also a last name. 太高了。Now to say thank you, 谢谢。谢谢，谢谢。That's thank you. Actually, the second 谢 is a neutral tone. 谢谢。So great, thank you. 太好了，谢谢。Let's try some sentences to ask someone's opinion. Remember, we often give your suggestion first, and then you check the other person's opinion. So 怎么说 ？How about you treat me to dinner?What you want to do is you want to say, you treat me to dinner. How about that? How does that sound? So, you treat me to dinner. 你请我吃晚饭。Remember to add the verb here. Eat dinner. 你请我吃晚饭。How about that? 怎么样?你请我吃晚饭。怎么样? How about we eat at 7? So you want to say, we eat at 7, how about that? Remember where to put the time expression in the sentence. 我们七点吃饭怎么样?我们七点吃饭怎么样?我们七点吃饭怎么样?Even though the how about goes at the very beginning of the sentence in English, remember that it goes at the end as a tag question in Chinese. Now, 怎么说 how about we eat Japanese food? To say Japan, again, it's 日本。日本。So you want to say we eat Japanese food, Japanese cuisine, how about that? 我们吃日本菜怎么样?我们吃日本菜怎么样? How about 8 o'clock? So you want to say 8 o'clock, how about that? 八点怎么样?八点怎么样? How about tomorrow night? So you want to say tomorrow night, how about that?明天晚上怎么样?明天晚上怎么样? What do you think of this college? So it's like saying, this college. How does that sound? What is that? How is that? This college. 怎么说 college? 很好。大学。大学 is college. 怎么说 this college?这个大学，这个大学怎么样? How is this college? 这个大学怎么样? Now, 听好, listen. 你喜欢吃中国菜吗? 你喜欢吃中国菜吗?你,你是什么?很好, you, 喜欢, it's a new word, we don't know. 吃, eat, 中国菜, Chinese cuisine, 吗? Obviously makes it a yes on the question. So what is 喜欢? 喜欢 means to like. 喜欢, 喜欢, to like. So when you say, 你喜欢吃中国菜吗? Do you like Chinese cuisine? You like eating Chinese cuisine? Question mark. So do you like Chinese cuisine? Now, 怎么说 I like you? 我喜欢你。我喜欢你。Do you like me? So remember, In a yes or no question, the sentence order, the word order remains the same, just add a question particle at the end of the statement. So, do you like me?
你喜欢我吗？你喜欢我吗？
I don't like you.
我不喜欢你。我不喜欢你。
Now, if I say, 你喜欢吃美国菜吗？
你喜欢吃美国菜吗？
什么意思？
你喜欢吃美国菜吗？
很好。Do you like American cuisine? Do you like American food? Now, what if I ask you,
你喜欢吃中国菜还是美国菜？
Here, we said 你, you, 喜欢, like, 吃, eat, 中国菜, Chinese cuisine, 还是, it's something we don't know, 美国菜, American cuisine. Could you guess the meaning of 还是? 很好, 还是 means or, 还是, 还是。还是 forms an alternative question, so you are giving a person some choices to choose from. So usually you will say A 还是 B. A 还是 B, A or B. If you have more choices, you can say A, B, C, blah, 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 还是 Z. Essentially, you want to use 还是 to link the last two choices. A, B, C, 还是 D. Things like that.Is to form an alternative question, A 还是 B. Remember, in the question, alternative question, the word order is exactly the same as in a statement. Now let's try. How do we form a question with these pictures? Let me give you a hint. You want to say, is this girl 16 or 10? Is this girl 16 or 10?Years of age, obviously. 怎么说 this girl? 很好，这个女孩子，这个女孩子。 Now, 这个女孩子十六岁 year of age, 还是哦，十岁。这个女孩子十六岁还是十岁还是 or This girl is 16 or 18 or 10, 对不起。这个女孩子十六岁还是十岁。How about this one? Now let's form the question to say, is your dad a doctor or a lawyer? Is your dad a doctor or a lawyer?The word order is more like your dad is a doctor or lawyer.
你爸爸是医生还是律师？你爸爸是医生还是律师
？A 还是 B？ 很好。Now, how do we say, are we eating dinner at 7 or 7:30?Are we eating dinner at 7 or 7:30? Remember where you put the time expression in a sentence. 很好, as adverbial goes before the verb and after the subject.
我们七点钟吃饭还是七点半吃饭?我们七点钟吃饭。还是七点半吃饭。我们七点钟吃饭，还是七点半吃饭。
We eat at 7 o'clock or eat at 7:30. Now, how do we ask? Is today the first, third? 对不起, is today.First, second, or third?
今天是一号、二号还是三号？今天是一号、二号还是三号？
Use how to link the last two choices.
今天是一号、二号还是三号？
Are you treating me to dinner, or am I treating you to dinner? Are you treating me to dinner, or am I treating you to dinner?
你请我吃晚饭，还是我请你吃晚饭？你请我吃晚饭，还是我请你吃晚饭？
How many alternative questions could you form based on this picture? Obviously, this is Jackie Chan, it's a cartoon. Now, for example, what if we want you to give some choices about his nationality? Could you say, is he Chinese or American?
他是中国人还是美国人？他是中国人还是美国人?
Is he Chinese or American? How about his gender? Let's say, is he a guy or a woman? 怎么说 a guy? It's male people, male person,
男人。
And woman is female people, female person,
女人。
So is he a male person, a guy, or a woman?
他是男人还是女人？他是男人还是女人？
怎么说？ How to ask his surname? Let's say, is he surnamed Chen or Bai? Is he surnamed Chen or Bai?
他姓陈还是白？他姓陈还是白？
Now let's ask about his first name. His first name is obviously Jackie. Let's say, is his first name, is he called Jackie or Jack?
他叫 Jackie 还是 Jack?
他叫 Jackie 还是 Jack? 很好。 Now,How do we say, do you like Chinese food, American food, or English food? Literally, it's more like, you like Chinese food, American food, or English food.
你喜欢中国菜、美国菜。
Now, how do we say English food? It's 英国菜、英国、British.England,
英国菜。
So to say, do you like Chinese food, American food, or English food?
你喜欢中国菜、美国菜还是英国菜？
怎么说 I am American, but I like Chinese food?
怎么说 but? 可是，可是
but I am American.
我是美国人
but
可是
I like Chinese food
我喜欢中国菜我是美国人可是我喜欢中国菜
那怎么说 I like my Chinese teacher but I don't like my English teacher
我喜欢我的中文老师，可是我不喜欢我的英文老师。我喜欢我的中文老师，可是我不喜欢我的英文老师。 怎么说 I have two older brothers, but I don't have any younger brothers?
我有两个哥哥。
Remember, 两 in front of the measure word to say two of something.
我有两个哥哥。可是我没有弟弟。
Once again, don't have, it's 没有。
可是我没有弟弟。我有两个哥哥。可是我没有弟弟。
I treated him to eat a meal, but he wouldn't treat me to eat a meal.
我请他吃饭。可是他不请我吃饭。我请他吃饭。可是他不请我吃饭。
那怎么说 I will treat you to eat American food tonight. Is that okay? 那怎么说 tonight? Tonight is today evening. So tonight is today evening.
今天晚上。
Let's think where we want to put 今天晚上 tonight in the sentence. 很好 as adverbial before the verb and after the subject.
So 我今天晚上请你吃美国菜。
Is that okay? You can say 怎么样 or you can say 好吗 how is okay. How has the meaning of good, how also has the meaning of okay. So to make it, is that okay? Okay, make a yes or no question, 好吗
So 我今天晚上请你吃美国菜怎么样
怎么说 great? What time tonight?Great! What time tonight?
太好了
Extremely good! 太好了 What time tonight? If you don't know how to form the question to say what time tonight, give a random answer to say 8 o'clock tonight. Remember how we put time expressions together. 很好 from bigger to smaller. So is tonight bigger or is what time bigger? 很好 tonight is bigger, so it goes first. So,今天晚上 what time? What is the question pronoun that we replace numbers with?
很好几
So 今天晚上几点 what time?
太好了今天晚上几点
How about 6:30? So you want to again give your suggestion then check to say how about that? So
六点半怎么样六点半怎么样
How about 6:30? Okay, see you tonight. 怎么说 okay? Once again, okay is how. How has many different meanings. How means nice, how means good, how means okay, how means well. So here, how also means okay. So you want to say how, see you tonight. Now once again, tonight is today evening. So 今天晚上。怎么说 see you tonight?First of all, see is to say see, it's 见
见
见 And to say see you tonight, we actually say a time plus 见 it means see you at this time. If you have a place plus 见 it means see you at this place. So to say see you tonight, literally it's just tonight, the time, plus 见 So,
今天晚上见
See you at this time. 今天晚上见 You don't have to literally translate the 我 here, the 你 here, you. You don't have to translate the 你 Just time plus 见 It means see you at this time. Place plus 见 See you at this place. So 今天晚上见 See you tonight. Now let's do more examples. 怎么说 see you tomorrow? 很好明天见明天见See you on Monday.
星期一见。星期一见。
See you in China.
中国见。中国见。 See you in New York.
纽约见。纽约见。
So once again, when you have a time or place plus 见, it means see you at this time, see you at this place. Now we know how to say see you at this time, see you at this, in this place. How do we say goodbye? To say goodbye, it's 再见。
再见。
再见。It means literally see you again.
见 means to see.
再 means again. So see you again, that's goodbye.
再见。